Hello and welcome to a brand new episode of No Full Stops with a brand new me. Hi, I am Megha. We begin the episode by looking at how exercise can be an important aspect when it comes to leading a fit and healthy life post-retirement.
For 62-year-old David, life post-retirement was more than just taking a walk in the park. Unlike people his age, he in fact went a step further and walked straight into a martial arts class to learn Tai Chi.
Well, I thought of it as a system that would keep me fit, keep me active, and allow me to defend myself if ever the need arose, because senior citizens today need to learn to take care of themselves.
David took to Tai Chi 2 years ago. The meditative technique of this martial art offered him a better option to stay fit than other vigorous exercise regimes.
I had had a heart attack. I had lost my balance completely. I couldn't walk in a straight line. And I was suffering from a mild depression after that. But I think Tai Chi has brought me out of all this. It's improved my flexibility, my balance. It keeps me in a very healthy and positive mood. And of course, I know how to look after myself today.
For people like David, aging is a mere number game in years. The more the years, the more the chance to earn brownie points with life. Aging is a natural and gradual process. As age progresses, it slows down some of the bodily functions, leading to some common problems like aches and pains, weak muscle, and reduction in stamina. But the interesting fact is that these are mere attributes of an inactive life and not directly related to the very process of aging. Physical inactivity therefore being the main culprit, and old age its mere accomplice. At 50, Savitri Raj is doing everything possible to make sure she feels as young as she felt when 30. An ardent fan of yoga, she has been practicing this ancient science for the last 29 years.
Yoga brought me so many changes in my life. Flexibility, and it strengthens my body, and it increases the immunity of my body, and memory power, and tolerance.
Having experienced the many benefits of yoga, Savitri has now started teaching it to others as well. Leading a life that is active, whether in terms of sports or exercise, is a key to a fit and healthy life post-retirement. Exercising benefits old age in more than one ways.
Exercise has three different impacts a person at three different levels. One is the physical level or the physiological level. One is the mental level or the psychological level, and one is the social level. So one of the most important point of the physical level, or what is also called as physiological level, is maintenance or gain of independence. As the balance increases, they don't have to use walker or a walking stick to commute. They don't have to, when the muscular strength increases, they don't have to ask somebody else to pick them up from the bed. The ab muscles are stronger, the core muscles are stronger, they can themselves get up from the bed. The sense of balance has its integrity, they can walk around without any problem. All these things are intricately linked with fitness and health.
A fitness trainer, Amit Sharma, says that older people must aim for exercises that will help improve their cardiovascular system, their flexibility and balancing skills. One of the common problems that older people face is unsteady balance, which could lead to sudden falls. So to improve balance, one simple yet effective exercise is to walk over an imaginary line by placing each step in front of the other, keeping feet as close as possible. Repeat the exercise by walking backwards as well. Another exercise is to hold the chair and lift one leg up. Hold till a count of 10 and then raise the other leg up. Do this for a couple of weeks and then move on to holding the chair with only a finger. and finally without any support. Once you have managed this, then repeat the entire exercise with eyes shut, but make sure someone is always around you when you do it. For strengthening the back, lie on the stomach and lift one hand and the opposite leg. Hold for as long as you can and repeat the same with the other hand and leg. Called the Superman exercise, this helps strengthen the lower back muscle. Another good strength training exercise is the hip raise. Lie down on the floor and bend your knees to get your feet as close to the buttocks as possible. Then tighten your hip and raise them as much as you can. This exercise helps improve core strength and hip strength. Another exercise for strengthening the back is the hip stretch, once again done lying down on the floor. Raise one leg at a time to the chest level and then both the legs together. This exercise is good for the lower back, but people with high blood pressure are advised against it.
It's never too late to start. Scientific, proper scientific, long-term research has shown, not just research with 10-12 people, but with huge number of people, that even if you start exercising at the age of 85, it will give you major benefits. If you have never exercised before, walking even 10 minutes a day can have a significant impact on your health.
Though the exercises are simple, do not attempt these without consulting your doctor and getting a proper physical examination done.